Hey guys, it's Ryan.
And Jenna.
And if you want to check out what we're doing when we're not here on Bin's Toy Bin, go check out our channel at whatsryantrying.com.
Just when you need a little bit more Ryan.
Everybody needs a little more Ryan.
I know.
Everyone, it's John
and Ryan,
and guess what? It's time for another week of
What's Ryan Trying.
And as you may or may not know from these giant cups with our names on them, cheers, Ryan. We are going to be doing the drink challenge today. Ben and Jenna went to the grocery store and picked out how many ingredients did you girls pick?
12 total.
12 ingredients. So each of us will have to pick out 6 random drink ingredients, put them in these cups, and whoever can drink the most of our concoction is going to be the winner of the drink challenge.
Okay, and you'll see we have 6 little marks here, so I'm guessing each ingredient has to get filled up to each line, which is, that's going to be a really full cup.
It is.
It's a 32-ounce cup.
And we wanted to make sure you didn't spill it when you were trying to drink it, so we got you special straws.
Special straws.
You have straws with the mustaches!
The mighty mustache!
The mighty mustache!
Okay. I can get behind that.
So we're going to pick numbers randomly out of this box. I'll shake it up. And Jenna is the guardian of the drink. And unlike the smoothie challenge, there is no blender required. These are all liquid drinks, correct?
Correct.
And they're all cold, I think.
Yes, they're all cold.
So far, so good.
Yeah. I'm curious what they came up with, but maybe it won't be too bad.
Yeah, I'm hoping it'll be all right. I mean, I'm hoping it won't, you know, it might be different, but just not disgusting. You know, if it's a little bit gross, I can handle it, but as long as it's not like, you know, cat food or, you know, something really disgusting in there.
So are we going to do rock, paper, scissors again to see who goes first?
Sounds good.
All right.
So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, and then actually go on 4.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, okay. Yeah. Ready? One, two, three, go.
Darn it. I'm not very good at that. You know, there are like real competitions where people play rock, paper, scissors. And they can tell by the way you move your elbow if you're going to do paper, I guess.
That means I get to choose. I can either volunteer to go first or I can hand it over to Ryan. And I'm going to shock you guys. I think I'm going to go first this week.
Okay.
Okay, Jenna. Get ready with those drinks. I got drink number 9.
Now, are they labeled in there or are you just guessing?
That'd be funny if I just like pull something out randomly.
The cap has the number on it.
Okay.
All right, interesting. What do we got
banana
here?
Banana? Oh, no. I thought it said banana.
It says Baya? 5?
I was looking at the bottom.
Antioxidant infusion.
Sumatra dragon fruit.
That doesn't sound
bad. Is it made with real dragon, I wonder?
Like, I actually want to try that when you're done.
There's some of these that I want to try, too.
We purchased some of these because we wanted to actually try them.
Okay, that makes... Well, that's...
So does that make you feel better?
Using muscles.
They don't want anyone to feel this precious dragon fruit.
I know.
It's guarded.
It smells delicious. It smells like Kool-Aid.
Ooh, it does smell really good.
Yeah, it reminds me of like Kool-Aid. I'm sure that's not what the dragon fruit people were going for. Okay, there we go. Ooh. I am going to take a sip of this, see how it is. That's really good.
It's a super fruit, it says on the back.
And Ryan picked out number...
Number 4. Oops, sorry.
You know, maybe we'll come up with, like, an awesome drink.
Stee's iced green tea. Raspberry.
Raspberry green tea. Hold that to the camera.
Zero calories. The best tasting natural green tea beverage on the planet, it says.
We went shopping in the organic section.
Yeah.
Ooh, it smells good, too.
I think that's the first one we came to.
Mm-hmm. Mmm, that's pretty good. It tastes like a raspberry cookie.
Okay, I'm going to pick out my next number. And
Ryan's looks
is...
a little low on the...
Ryan.
Is it? Oh, I guess you're right. From there? Well, from my angle, looking at the top, it looks perfect. Doesn't that look... From this angle, doesn't that look
perfect? It does. Well, I have number 7 while he's topping off his drink.
Now I went a little too far.
What is this? This looks alcoholic. We can't show this on our channel.
It's not alcoholic.
It's a product of France.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
I want to try that one.
There goes our French audience. This is sparkling blueberry lemonade. I've never heard of blueberry lemonade. You're sure this is non-alcoholic?
It is non-alcoholic.
I bought it in the juice section.
All right. Now, look how much...
She measured it with a ruler. I think it's just an optical illusion, because, well, see, mine's up too high a little bit now.
Okay. How's that look?
Nice.
Interesting. It's carbonated. It tastes like carbonated lemonade. It's like soda and lemonade together. I don't really taste any blueberry in it, though.
I'm pleasantly surprised so far.
I know. This is going to be a very nice drink.
Number eight.
I'm excited, and there's nothing that could rain on our parade now. What is this?
What is this? Sparkling water? Sparkling natural mineral water.
So we're going healthy on this challenge.
Yeah.
Bottled in France. Oh, we got a real French theme going here.
Perrier.
Okay, pull it
the
up.
The bottle, I feel like I should... I don't know what it tastes like. Whew, it's kind of strong. I wouldn't drink it on its own, but...
So far, so good. This is going to be like a sparkling carbonated fruit punch. I think they went really easy. I think they felt bad after those tin cans last week.
Yeah.
So I got number six here, everyone.
Wah.
What have we here? It's a chilled can of tomato juice from concentrate.
That probably won't be that bad.
Made only with peak season tomatoes. So, tomato juice in with my lemonade and my, well, whatever that raspberry stuff. Dragon fruit.
Dragon fruit, yeah.
It's all fruits.
Okay, here we...
It's a little thick.
Yeah, I was gonna add some...
Yeah, you need to use the whole can.
There we go. I think I'll pass on taking a sip out of that.
Yeah, but, you know...
I will swirl it around. Now my drink smells like tomato soup.
Yeah.
All right, well, then definitely interesting.
Number 10.
What is that little...
Fruit shoot. Orange. Naturally orange-flavored juice drink from concentrate.
I think you're going to have to pour that whole thing in there.
It's not going to change the color.
I would change it a little bit.
It's going to take most of it.
I thought it was going to be a lot more orangey.
Me too.
Like Sunny D.
Yeah.
All right, so next number for me. I think you have the winning drink so far.
I didn't want to say it because I don't want to jinx myself.
Number one.
You're always number one.
Oh, another one of these, but this one is...
Is this the one we wanted to try?
This is lemon flavor.
How is that a superfruit? Isn't that what it says? Neither.
Lemons are very good for you.
Hmm.
Ugh.
All right, so I got tomato lemonade going on.
When life gives you lemons.
This is pretty good, too. I'm not sure how it'll go with tomato juice, but we'll give it a try. All right, Ryan's turn.
Oops. Number 12, coconut lime. I don't like lime. Another product of France. Fresh lime and coconut create a refreshing drink for all occasions.
Hmm.
Contains no juice. Carbonated water, sugar, natural flavor, citric acid. Oh, that is weird. All I can think of is, sunscreen, the coconut flavored sunscreen. Not flavored, but coconut smelling.
All right, we're down to the final one, two, three. Down to the final four drinks.
Yeah.
Okay. Next in my drink is number 11. They're laughing. What is this?
Lemon cayenne.
Lemon cayenne? That's a drink?
Why would you buy that?
It's sparkling probiotic.
Why wouldn't you buy it?
But it's pepper and lemon.
It's a sweet and savory mix here.
No, I think it... That's got to be a joke. You put your nose right in there.
You smell that. It smells like spicy lemonade.
It doesn't smell that bad, actually. I don't like lemonade, but it doesn't smell bad.
Right, I'm going to take a sip before I pour it into my mixture here.
Hope it's not hot.
Oh, yeah, it's got a... It's very, it does have a aftertaste to it. You got to try this. Oh, and look, I have to fill it up to there as the cup gets wider near
the
top.
Now I said the same thing. As the cup gets wider. The same distance is giving a little more volume, but...
Yeah, it tastes like lemonade when you first drink it, but it definitely has a kick to it.
Give me that shot.
Yeah, take a shot out of that. It doesn't taste bad when you first drink it, but it has that at the end.
Oh, yeah. Number three.
More sparkling water.
Lime.
Is that tonic
water? Mine's just going to taste like, I think I've had almost all citrus.
You're going to be able to chug that whole glass while I have the cayenne peppers and the tomato in mine. All right, two left.
I don't like lime. It's going to be flavors I don't like, but it's not going to be like really gross.
Number two. This is my last ingredient.
Oh, Gatorade.
It's funny how mine kind of went for the red theme.
Yeah. I would love to have some fruit punch Gatorade in
here's
mine.
Here's a classic. Let's see.
We picked that for you.
I know. I wish I had it to maybe mask some of this lime.
All right. Look at that. It's very red.
Wow, that's a really nice looking drink. So, number five. Ooh, an Arnold Palmer half and half. So, yeah, mine is going to be... That is strange how that happened.
I think you got the easier one
But
here.
Again, it's half lemonade, half iced tea. My whole thing has been tea and
lemonade.
Whoops, spilling everywhere.
I do think they were kind of easy on us overall. I was expecting like chocolate milk or mixed with Dr. Pepper or something.
No, I think we wound up in like organic section first.
Arnie Palmy.
All right,
you can't drink it. Yeah, I gotta get you your...
Yeah, I want to mix mine up anyway. So I wish I had a recap of everything that was in mine because I've forgotten a lot of it. I got orange... Lime.
All right, everyone. Here, these are nice, refreshing summer drinks. I have a little bit of everything in mind. Yours is just the lime, and tea.
Yeah, and two types of tea, some sparkling water, and lime.
So, yeah.
Other citrus.
What did I have in mind? I have Gatorade, tomato juice, this weird lemonade,
the
cayenne pepper thing.
The dragon fruit.
Oh, yeah, that's good. Yeah, so mine was definitely red. That was the theme of mine. Okay, so what should we call this? What would you call this drink? Let me know down in the comments, because I got nothing. And so whoever can drink the most out of their drink wins this challenge. All
right, we have convenient marks on the side of your cup.
Turn mine around so you can see how well I do.
Okay.
I just think I'm going to get tripped up on the tomato juice.
The tomato juice, it was a little thick, but hopefully it'll kind of be thinned out.
Yeah.
With the Gatorade, and I think the Gatorade's the only thing that would save it for me.
Okay.
I just want to point out before anybody comments down below that John's cup looks like it's more full than Ryan's, but it's just because these are cheap dollar store glasses and Ryan's is a little taller, but they're the same amount of liquid in both.
Yeah, we measured from the bottom up to the mark, so it's the same, but yeah, they're...
This is like teetering.
I don't know, I think I want to recount.
Mine's quite a bit taller.
Yeah, but you they can see that the liquids are the same amount.
All right, here we go.
One, two, three, go.
Oh, I'm doing it wrong.
Oh.
Ryan, I think you can beat him this time.
We just got a big kick of that that coconut.
That is vile. I can taste nothing but tomato with peppery aftertaste. But I'm not going to give up. I'm going to beat Ryan.
I'm going to drink this whole thing. It's actually not bad. I mean, it's not like anything that I would ever make myself because I don't like lemons or limes or coconuts or tonic water. But it's not bad.
Oh!
It does kind of taste... Mine tastes like if you got sunscreen in your mouth, like that coconut-scented sunscreen.
Oh.
It's not great, but I'm almost down to the next line.
It does go down a little, even though it's very unpleasant, it does go down a bit easier than that smoothie.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is way better than the smoothie. It's way better than last week's can challenge. I could drink the whole thing if I had to. It's just not my favorite.
Ryan, what's that over there?
Considering that splattered all over my leg, I kind of know what you did. I think that since you cheated, I win. Yeah.
So Ryan, I hate to admit it, is the winner of this week's drink challenge.
Just the luck of the draw, though.
Yeah, I ended up getting the two grossest ones out of...
With as many lime and lemon things, I think that we could have each... If we had drawn differently, I think we could have had very similar drinks if we mixed them all.
Yeah, I agree, yeah.
Because mine is just overwhelmingly lemon and citrus.
I
bet Ryan's is good.
I think if I didn't have that tomato juice, I think it would have been a much closer contest.
Yeah?
Because that's literally all you can taste. Anybody want a sip of this?
Hello. Hello.
Ugh.
Drink up.
Well, yeah.
Mix it up.
Oh. Whoops, that was an accident.
It looks like Ryan won the drink challenge. I don't know what we have in store next week. I don't even think Ben and Jenna have planned it out that far yet.
No. I know that there was something about some hard-boiled eggs.
Oh, no, not egg roulette.
That's what I heard a rumor.
They've been requesting that since the beginning. I know. Ryan trying.
Ever since we gave them the Bean Boozled, that was the next one that they wanted.
So, yeah, be sure to let us know down in the comments what you would name my drink and what you would name Ryan's drink. Don't forget to subscribe to us, Ben's Toy Bin, right here on YouTube. But don't forget that Ryan and Jenna also have their own YouTube channel now.
WhatsRyanTrying.com.
And they also have Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, because they're now in the 21st century.
Yeah, we're really moving ahead here.
We're moving up in this world.
So thanks for watching, everybody. See you next week for Egg Roulette.